मॉर्निंग, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीबॉडी। गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीबॉडी। आई वांट योर रिप्लाई। Good morning and assalamu alaikum everybody. Can you hear me? Okay, Fauzia. Okay, just give me 2 seconds to admit all the students. Okay, class 10, last night I uploaded your syllabus of quiz number 2. Walaikum salam Aisha beta. Okay, what I was telling you that last night I have uploaded your syllabus of quiz number 2 and your quiz will be conducted on Thursday means 6th of August 2020. I have uploaded the syllabus on Google Classroom. I hope everybody has seen the syllabus. I have included first 4 tenses in upcoming quiz, which will be held on 6th of August 2020, means Thursday. The syllabus is present indefinite tense, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. These 4 tenses I have included for your quiz number 2. I hope everybody has seen. If you have not seen yet, kindly have a look on Google Classroom. I have uploaded. Okay, so let's start the lecture now. Okay, as I was telling you that last lecture was a review of dignity of work. Our last lecture was a review of dignity of work. And what I have told you that in review of the lesson, I want your complete involvement and your participation in lecture. I will ask you the questions. And if you remember, I have included half of the lesson on Monday. So remaining half of the lesson, we are going to do it today. So today is our lecture number 20. And date is 29th of July 2020. Okay, today we have lecture number 20 and date is 29th of July 2020. Okay, so today's, I know that you, all of you have written your present in the chat box. It's good. You all are supposed to write your present in the chat box. But one thing I want to tell you that today's attendance is dependent on the answers that I will, the questions that I will ask you, okay? I will take your names, I will call out your names, and by your name, you will give me the answer of the question, whatever I will ask you. And if the student will give me the answer, it doesn't matter if it is wrong or right. It doesn't matter if your answer is wrong or right. I just want your involvement. I want your contribution in my today's lecture. So the one who will answer me my question, either it is wrong or right, I will mark only his or her attendance. The one who will not give me the answer, I will mark his or her absence. And please, not all of you all together are supposed to give me the answers. I will call out your name. By calling out your names, you will give me the answers. Are you getting me, class 10? Today is our lecture number 20 and date is 29th of July 2020. And today we are going to have a review of remaining lesson, The Dignity of Work. Half of the lesson was left. So in today's lecture, we are going to complete the review of the remaining lesson. And in this review, you people are going to give me the answers of the questions that I will ask you. The one who will answer me the questions, only his present will be marked. Otherwise, I will mark your absent. Okay? So let's move towards the lecture. Okay. So let's move towards the lecture now. So as I told you that today's lecture is again a review, and review of the remaining lesson, that was Dignity of Work. Okay, half of the lesson we have completed in our previous lecture, and remaining lesson we are going to complete it today. And I'm telling you that only I will mark attendance of those students who will give their 100% involvement and contribution in my lecture. If the student will not give me the answer, I will mark his or her absent. Okay, it doesn't matter that you are going to give me the wrong answer. Koi baat nahi. It doesn't matter either the answer is right or wrong. I only want is your participation, your involvement, your contribution. So don't worry if you are giving me the wrong answers, okay? So let's move towards the lecture now. Okay, again, obviously review of lesson number 8. And the name of the lesson is Dignity of Work, and page number is 28. Okay, so if you're having your books with you, kindly close your books, because it's kind of a review. You have already done these things, you have already studied this lesson in detail, so you will give me the answers verbally without opening your books. Okay. Just we are going to have a quick review of all the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, what they have done. We will have a quick look on the working that were done by the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And after this, we are going to have question answers regarding these companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Okay, what Hazrat Abu Bakr has done? Hazrat Abu Bakr fetched water for widows and neighbors. Okay, just have a brief and quick look on these companions. What were the works which were done by these companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him? Okay, first of all, Hazrat Abu Bakr fetched water for widows and neighbors. Then Emperor Aurangzeb earned his living by transcribing the Holy Quran. What is the meaning of transcribing? I have given you the meaning of transcribing. The meaning of transcribing is to make a written copy of something. Okay? Transcribing means to make a written copy of. Yes. Daniel Gert. Transcribing means to make a written copy of. Okay, then Hazrat Umar. Hazrat Umar carried a sack of flour on his shoulders. Hazrat Umar carried sack of flour on his shoulders for a needy family. Okay, the students who have just joined me, I just want to tell you that today we are going to have a review of lesson number 8. The name of the lesson is Dignity of Work. Half of the lesson we have reviewed on Monday. So remaining lesson, we are going to have a review of the remaining lesson today. Today, review of this lesson, Dignity of Work, will be completed. But in this review, I want your contribution. I want your involvement. So that is why we are going to have a brief look, quick review on the workings of the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. What did companions of the Holy Prophet do? So just have a quick look on their working, and later on, you people are going to give me the answers, okay? So once again, for the students who have joined me late, we are going to again going to start from Hazrat Abu Bakr. Hazrat Abu Bakr fetched water for widows and neighbors. Emperor Aurangzeb earned his living by transcribing the Holy Quran, and I have given you the meaning of transcribing in my previous lectures. The meaning of transcribing is to make a written copy of. Transcribing means to make a written copy of. Okay. Hazrat Umar. Hazrat Umar carried a sack of flour on his shoulders for a needy family. Hazrat Ali. Hazrat Ali labored in the garden of a Jew and gave away his wages in a charity. Okay. Gave away his wages in a charity. Hazrat Ali labored in the garden of a Jew and gave away his wages in charity. Okay, then comes Hazrat Fatima. Hazrat Fatima fetched water, ground corns, and swept her house. Sultan Nasiruddin earned his living by making caps. Okay, you have a look on all these workings done by the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Once again, have a quick look. Hazrat Abu Bakr fetched water for widows and needy family. Emperor Aurangzeb earned his living by transcribing Holy Quran. And the meaning of transcribing is to make a written copy of. Hazrat Umar carried sack of flour on his shoulders for a needy family. Hazrat Ali labored in the garden of a Jew and gave away wages in. Muhammad Daniel, we can write both. This comes in England, British version and American version. Okay. One, labored. This labored is American version and bored is British version. Okay. If you write it, if you type it, you will get both the options. Ured and ored. Okay. So, Hazrat Ali labored in the garden of a Jew and gave away his wages in the charity. Okay. Then comes Hazrat Fatima. Hazrat Fatima fetched water, ground corns, and swept the house. Sultan Nasiruddin earned his living by making caps. Okay, now get ready. We are going to have a question-answer session. Before I start question-answer session, I want to make this announcement that today's attendance is fully dependent upon your involvement and your contribution. Nobody will give me the answer until and unless I will ask you to give me the answer. I will call out your names. I will take out your names and you will give me the answer. Please don't give me the answers altogether. I don't want your answers until and unless I will ask you to give me the answer. Okay? Okay, let's start question answers now. Okay, now I am going to take your names. By names, I will ask you the question. First of all, Arham Faisal. Arham Faisal, are you there? Arham Faisal. Arham Beta, are you there? Arham, kindly give me the answer of this question. What did Hazrat Abu Bakr do? What did Hazrat Abu Bakr do? Arham, are you there? What did Hazrat Abu Bakr do? Okay, Shifa Farhan. Shifa Farhan, beta, give me the answer of this question. What did Hazrat Abu Bakr do? What did Hazrat Abu Bakr do? Yes, Harim, very good beta. Harim, you have given me right answer, but one thing you have done wrong. That is past tense you have to use, okay? Harim has written the answer. Hazrat Abu Bakr did his own work and fetched water for widows and neighbors. Very good, Nisha. Very good, Fauzia. Once again, only few girls, Shifa Gurd. Good, beta. Once again, only few girls are there who always give me the answers, like Shifa, Fauzia, Misha, Harim, Huria. Only few girls are there who always participate in their class. Whenever I ask them the questions, they answer me. I don't know what rest of the class is doing. Either they are sleeping or what they are doing, I don't know. I'm telling you that today I am going to mark your absence. I'm warning you, it's kind of a warning. If I mark your absence, please don't come to me. Daniel, when nobody has given me the answer, then you are allowed to give me the answer, okay? Daniel, when the particular student will not give me the answer, then you are allowed to give me the answer. Okay, next question is, what did Hazrat Fatima do? You all can give me the answer now. What did Hazrat Fatima do? Very good, Huria, Saneha, Nisha, Asra, very good. Faiza, very good. Yes, the right answer is Hazrat Fatima fetched water, ground corn, and swept the house. Hazrat Fatima swept, fetched water, ground corn, and swept the house herself. Okay, very good. Very good, Arshan. You also have participated. Keep it up, beta. Okay, now we are moving towards question number three. And question number three is, how did Sultan Nasiruddin earn his living? Who is going to give me the answer of this question? Yes, very good, Nisha, Asra, Daniel, very good. Sultan Nasiruddin earned his living by making caps. Sultan Nasiruddin earned his living by making caps. Very good, Ramisha, Raza. I'm really happy that you people are participating. This is what I want from you. I want your complete involvement and participation. This thing will boost up your confidence and your involvement in class. Very good. Sultan Nasiruddin earned his living by making caps. Okay, let's move forward. What does everyone do in China and what did teacher do himself in school? Who is going to give me the answer? What does everyone do in China? What did teacher do himself in school? In school, I have added myself. What does everyone do in China and what did teacher do himself in school? Hurry up, beta. Yes, Aisha, it should be does, okay? It should be does, not do, okay? In China, everybody is supposed to do some work in field or factory once in a year. Even the prime minister or president are also with their wives do work in fields or factory. And what did teacher do himself in school? Teacher emptied the dustbins and... Yes, very good. Very good. Everybody, those who are answering me, very good, beta. What does everyone do in China? In China, everybody is supposed to do some work in field or factory at least once in a year. And Prime Minister or President with their wives are also supposed to do work in field or factory. Okay? So what did teacher do himself? Teacher emptied the dustbins and dust the cupboards and desks. Okay? Very good. Okay, let's move forward. Shifa, good beta. Okay, what did the Holy Prophet love? What did the Holy Prophet love? Yes, very good. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, loved doing his work himself and even the works of other as well, like widows, the needy people, the people, the families who have nobody to help them out. Okay, very good, Ammar, very good, beta. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, loved to do his work himself and the work of others as well, like the needy people, like the widows and the families who have nobody to help them. Okay, last question of this lesson. Were the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, were the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, like him? Were the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, like him? Who is going to give me the answer? Fauzia beta, I have not asked you the question that did they like him. यहाँ पे like him पसंद करने के लिए नहीं आ रहा. Like him से मुराद है कि क्या हमारे अस्हाबाए कराम भी हजूर पाक सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की तरह थे, मतलब कि क्या वो भी अपना काम खुद ही किया करते थे. दानियाल बेटा, if you will give the answer like this, yes they were, you will not get the marks. Either at least you should add one or two examples at least. Okay, don't write like this, yes they were. At least give one or two examples also. Nabil and Danial, did you get me? Kindly give me the complete answer. Hurry up. At least one or two examples. Very good, Nisha. Nisha has given a very good answer. Yes, the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, were also like him, and they used to do their work themselves and for others as well. Very good, Huria, Harim, very good. Very good. Amna, Ammar, very good. Okay, so this was the question answers session. Now we are moving towards next slide, and our next slide is about reference to the context. Our next slide is reference to the context. Okay, first of all, we have to see the dialogue. What is the dialogue here? Very good, Shifa, you have given a very good answer by giving the examples of Hazrat Ali who worked in the garden of a Jew. Okay, but it looks so odd. First of all, name the speaker. Obviously, the name of the speaker is Akhtar. Very good. Name of the speaker is Akhtar. Name the listener. Who was the listener? Yes, listener was favorite uncle Inayat. Okay, listener was uncle Inayat. Last question of this reference to the context. What does look so odd and why? What does look so odd and why? What does look so odd and why? Yes, Asra, very good, very good, very good. To work like a servant or to do your work yourself looks odd. But can you give me the reason? Why did Akhtar said this? Why does it look so odd? What is the reason of looking so odd? Very good, Harim. This was the answer I was expecting. Because doing own work doesn't suit a gentleman, okay? Doing your own work yourself, doing your work yourself doesn't suit a gentleman at all, okay? So, once again, the speaker is Akhtar, listener is Uncle Inayat. What does look so odd and odd and why? Doing your own work yourself, doing your work yourself looks so odd, and the reason of why is because doing your work yourself doesn't suit a gentleman. Doesn't suit a gentleman. Very good. Amar, Faiza, Harim, very good. Okay, I'm really happy that you people are participating. Okay, now. Very good, Aisha. You have also given the good examples by taking these examples from your lesson. Okay, now we have, if you see the next slide, now you can see in the end of the lesson, two idioms are also given. The first one is by fits and starts, and the second one is day in and day out. First of all, the meanings of these idioms. By fits and starts means not steadily or regularly. किसी चीज को मुसलसल लगातार बाकायदगी के साथ ना करना. Okay? Day in and day out means daily, day after day. यानी कि रोजाना, हर दिन बाकायदगी के साथ. अच्छा. Last time I have told you in my previous lectures as well that there are idioms which are given at the end of your lessons in your book. Please don't take these idioms non-seriously or lightly, because these idioms are of 6 marks. The questions of these idioms are given to you in your paper, and question carries 6 marks. So what you are supposed to do, you have to learn the meanings of these idioms. And this is a very good thing that sentences are also given in your book. Okay? Sentences of these idioms. Sentences of these idioms are also given in your books with their meanings. If you feel like that you people are not good at making sentences yourself, you can learn the sentences which are already given in your book. But if you feel like you can make your own sentences, then it is well and good. You can use your own sentences, make your own sentences. But the basic thing is to learn these idioms with your meanings. जब तक आपको इन idioms के meanings याद नहीं होंगे, you people will not be able to make sentences of these idioms. So the key point is, the basic element is, the main thing is to learn these idioms with their meanings. To learn these idioms with their meanings. The basic thing, the basic element, the key point is to learn the meanings of these idioms. Once you will know the meanings of these idioms, it will be easier for you to use them in your sentences. Okay, now you people are going to make sentences. First one is by fits and starts. Guria has made a sentence. The economy of Pakistan is recovering by its fits and starts. Very good, Guria. Very good sentence you have made. Faiza has made a sentence. He does his homework by fits and starts. Very good. Very good, girls. Anybody else? By fits and starts. Anybody else who wants to make a sentence by fits and starts? Hurry up, Pila, hurry up. Only 2 girls have made. Anybody else who wants to make a sentence of the idiom by Fritz and Starr. Nobody is there. Michelle, you can take it in any sense. Okay. By its structure, we cannot say that your sentence is wrong. Technology advances by fits and starts. Very good. Technology advances by fits and starts. Okay, good. Anybody else who wants to make sentence of by fits and starts? We have to work day in and day out for the prosperity of our country. Very good, Harim. Very good, Harim. You are making very good sentences. We have to work day in and day out for the prosperity of our country. Aisha Ansari has made a sentence. The servants work day in and day out just to earn money for their families. Very good. Okay, Daniel. Very good. I do my homework day in and day out. Sabiha, we have to drink milk day in and day out. Arsal, I have been working hard for my exams day in and day out. Very good, Arsal. You also have made a very good sentence. Anybody else? Anybody else who wants to make sentences by using these two idioms? Okay, Nabil, good attempt, Peter. I play cricket day in and day out. I used to drink coffee day in and day out. Okay, it means, Michelle, you are talking about past. Because used to drink is something about past. Yani ki piya karti thi. I used to drink coffee day in and day out. Main baqaidgi se coffee piya karti thi. Piya karti thi. Something about used to means piya karte the. The laborers work day in and day out for making building. Okay. Good. One should work by fits and starts to earn for his family. Harim, no. Peter, you are not getting the meaning of by fits and starts. Fits and starts means किसी चीज को बाकायदगी से ना करना. Okay. यहाँ पर आप second वाला idiom ये use कर सकती हो. डे इन एंड डे आउट वाला यूज कर सकती हो कि बाकायदगी से हमें कोई काम करना चाहिए अपने खानदान की अर्निंग के लिए. ओके, बाय फिट्स एंड स्टार्ट्स का मतलब तो ये कि नॉट रेगुलरली, किसी चीज को कुछ दिन छोड़ के करना, फिर करना, फिर ना करना, नॉट रेगुलरली. ओके ओके, एनीबॉडी एल्स? Anybody else who wants to make any sentence, or should we move forward? Okay, so class 10, this was okay, let's check the sentence. One who works by fits and starts is sweet to a miserable end. Beta is nahi aayega Hari. One who works by fits and starts leads to a miserable end. Okay, is nahi aayega. Okay, okay, so what is your task to do? You have to review today's lecture carefully and thoroughly. You have to learn the meanings of the difficult word, and after my lecture I am going to upload your assignment on Google Classroom. Your written assignment of dignity of work, I am going to upload it on Google Classroom. You have to do this assignment in your literature journals. And please, class 10, please maintain the indices of your journal. You people are not taking your indices carefully. Most of the students have not maintained their indices of the journal. Please make the title page of your lesson, write down the proper date and name of the topic, okay? You have to maintain the indices of your journals. One more thing I want to tell you is that whenever you are going to do any poetry, whenever you are going to do any poetry, it should be understood that you have to write the reference of the poet and you have to write the poem in your journal. Writing poem is understood. I will not ask you again and again to write the poem in your journal. If I forget to ask you to write the poem in your journal, it should be understood by you people that you are doing a poetry, and it is understood that you have to write a poem in your journal. Okay? You have to write a poem in your journal, and this thing is understood. I will not ask you again and again. Sometimes a teacher can forget this thing to remind you these things. So it should be understood by you people that if you are doing a poetry, you are supposed to write a poem in your journal as well. I hope I am clear. Okay, class 10, I hope, as I informed you in the start of the lecture, that yesterday night, I have uploaded your syllabus and date of quiz number 2. Your next quiz will be conducted on Thursday. Your next quiz will be conducted on Thursday, means 6th of August 2020. And syllabus of quiz number 2 is first four tenses. First four tenses: present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous are the four tenses which I have included for your quiz number 2. Okay? So class 10, I hope everybody has written their attendance in the chat box. Everybody has written the attendance in chat box, I hope. Nobody is left. Okay, Ryan. Beta, you have not participated in anything. Lots of questions I have asked you, but you have not answered me even a single question. Abdul Rahman, you have not given the answer of any question. I don't know what you people are doing. Saad Ahmed, but whenever I ask you to write your attendance, you give me your attendance very quickly and promptly. But when I ask you to give me the answers of any question, you people don't give me the answers at all. So what should I do? Should I mark your attendance as an absent student? What should I do? Kindly tell me. What should be the punishment now? You people are not taking any kind of part in class discussions, question answer sessions. Saad, I have given you the reason that I have asked lots of questions, but you people have not answered me at all. You and including other students as well, like Ryan, Abdul Rahman, Arham Faisal, and many other students are there who are not participating in class discussions, who are not giving me the answers. I know what you people are doing, Vita. You have to be very, very attentive during the class, and whatever teacher asks you, you should answer me, beta. This is a healthy habit. Kindly develop this habit that kindly participate in class discussions and question answers, whatever the teacher is asking you to answer. Okay. So I hope that everybody has given the attendance. Yes, Aisha, you have to write the poem in your journals. Whenever you will do the poetry, you have to write poem in your journals, okay? Okay, till my next lecture, Vida. Now, after Eid, inshallah, after Eid, we are going to have our class. So, till then, stay home, stay safe, take very good care of yourself. Thank you, and Allah Hafiz.